yeni bir kanser olduk adına. Kanserin de stemir fraktör. Benim kontaksiyonu da kardeşler sağlık basit kubat fraktör, kanser fraktör. Normal bir mekanizmanın müdürlüğü slip control. Like if you slip, in a banana peel if you slip. That kind of injury results into the fracture of the patella. Because of causes sudden contraction of the quadriceps muscle. The displacement of this fracture is prevented by intact pre-patellar expansion of quadriceps in front and patellar patella on the sides. Picture shows the type of patella fracture, that is, this is two part transverse fracture. If you see it laterally, if you see it anteriorly in anterior, this is two part fracture, transverse, in the palm pedunculum. This is the skeletal type of fracture. Picture B shows the skeletal type of fracture, combined with patellar fracture. There is also one type of fracture which is known as vertical fracture. I think there is a W in X-ray. Yeah. This is the vertical fracture. You see in X-ray in skyline view, vertical kind of patellar fracture is seen clearly in this kind of view. Now what are the clinical features of patellar fracture? It is same, pain, swelling, local vessel temperature, the bruising or atomosis, thickness of patella can be felt, there is patella gap which can be felt, which is targeted to fracture. Patient is not able to lift the leg in full leg extension. The diagnosis is done by again the X-rays, AP and lateral view. Scarring is used for diagnosing the fracture of vertical patella. This is a scarring view, this is how you take. This is the position of the knee. The X-ray has been taken from this side and the film is cut from here. One side the film is cut, the projector is from the other side. This is a scarring view, so is a fracture, which is a vertical kind of fracture patella. Transverse fracture patella is not that much appreciated in scarring view. But this is a post-operative fracture, the post-operative fracture of the patella, that comes in the wiring, in AP and lateral view. Figure of 8. Pre-cut of endoscopic fracture patella is usually a cylindrical cast from groin to just above the malleoli with the knee in extension for 3 weeks, it is given. Pre-cut fracture, that is either plaster or vertical fracture, what do you do? Open reduction and tension band wiring fixation. That is the reduction of fragmentary tension band wiring and repair of the extensor retina below. If accurate reduction is not possible or if there are many communicative pieces, cartilectomy with the extensor, retinocular repair is done. If the fragment consists of only one pole, that is one pole of the patella is intact, other pole of the patella is highly communicated, either lower one or superior one. We undergo the partial cartilectomy of that pole, which is severely communicated. In communicated fracture, if the entire patella is severely or badly communicated, we go for total cartilectomy. To prevent the osteoarthritis in the metastatic stage. Complication again it is the same, that is knee stiffness, extensor weakness and osteoarthritis. Now we will discuss about the injuries to the ligaments. Collateral ligaments. Both medial and lateral collateral ligaments are extracapsular structure. They provide coronal plane stability and it resists valgus and varus process of the knee. Two collateral ligaments that we discussed earlier in the anatomy, medial collateral ligament and lateral collateral ligament. Medial collateral ligament is also known as spinal collateral ligament. Lateral is also known as similar collateral ligament. Medial collateral ligament is present medially. So how it will be damaged or how it will be injured? If the medial collateral ligament has to be injured, the force will be given from the lateral step of the knee. That is a valgus force. But it ruptures from its femoral attachment. This is the most common ligament injury around the knee. Whereas lateral collateral ligament is injured, then there will be varus force, that is the force is given medially. And the knee goes laterally. It gets averse from the head of the fulna with a piece of bone, also known as Cezanne's fracture. This is very uncommon injury. Now examination how in the examination of the knee. Valgus test and varus press test. So in valgus press test, the patient is asked to browse the time with the flexion of the knee. If the affected knee is flexed in 20 to 30 degrees and the examiner will apply a force. A valgus force will be applied by the examiner and the knee goes shift towards the medial side. one hand of the examiner is kept on the outer aspect of the limb, the other hand holds the ankle, and the virus force will be applied. If the test is positive, you will see there will be opening of the joint. That means it is suggestive of the medial collateral ligament rupture. The same test in the opposite direction is done to check the lateral collateral ligament. It is known as virus test. One hand of the examiner is kept on the medial side of the knee, other hand will be holding the ankle, and a virus force is applied towards the knee. If there will be opening of the joints, this lateral knee, that means there is injury of the lateral collateral ligament. Investigation. Normally, fractures are very easily seen in X-rays, but ligament injury, you have to go for higher investigation such as MRI. Radiologically, hamstring injury is classified into three types. Or in case of MRI, it is classified into three types. Grade 1, that is minor sprain. It is looks normal. Normally, it is treated conservatively minor sprain. Here, you can see this image. There is mild swelling. Not much. Grade 2, you see there is mild partial torn of the medial collateral ligament. And grade 3, there is complete white line that you can see between the two black structures medially. There is a white line. That means the ligament is completely torn. So this is the complete tear. Grade 2 is the placenta and grade 1 is mild sprain. So now we will discuss about the cruciate ligaments. They are the segmental plane stabilizer, whereas we discussed about the collateral ligaments, they were the coronal plane stabilizer of the knee. Cruciate ligaments, they are intracapsular but extrasynovial. Two types of cruciate ligaments are present in the knee, anterior and posterior. What are their functions? Functions of the anterior cruciate ligament is, it prevents the anterior translation of the tibia, prevents the hyperextension of the knee, it is a primary stabilizer of internal rotation of the knee. Function of posterior cruciate ligament, it prevents the posterior translation of the tibia, it is a primary stabilizer of external rotation of the knee. Now side, that is the origin and insertion of the cruciate ligament or site of attachment if it remains. And PCL is attached in the substance of the ligament and PCL is also the ligament from the bone, the site from which it gets injured. Mechanism of injury, ACL is usually injured by a twisting injury of the knee and PCL is usually injured by a posterior translation of the tibia, such as in case of basket injury of the knee. The clinical test, how you can check the ACL is injured or PCL is injured, the clinical test for ACL are anterior door test, the Lachman's test, which is the most sensible test, the 2XF test and the Lillow test. Test for PCL injury, posterior door test, reverse 5XF test and posterior side test. So, anterior door test for anterior PCL ligament injury. The patient is asked to lie supine. The examiner will set on the foot of the patient of the affected part of the knee when he is flexed at 20 to 30 degrees. And the examiner will hold the knee with the palm of the hand cut posteriorly and the thumb of the examiner will cut will be on the tibial condyles anteriorly. And the examiner will pull the leg forwards. The shifting of leg more than 5 mm. Normally, it is in case of normal person, again, you will see, you will find the normal translation of tibia, 2 to 3 mm is normal. But if it is more than 5 mm or extreme translation of the knee, if you can observe in this kind of test, that means the ACL is injured. The Lachman test. Again, the patient is asked to lie supine. The examiner will flex the knee 20 to 30 degrees. One hand of the examiner, that is the left hand, if you check the right leg of the patient, the left hand of the examiner will be on the lower aspect of the thigh and the right hand will be kept on the upper aspect of the leg. You will fix the thigh with the left hand and the right hand will pull the upper aspect of the knee forwards. Again the same thing, the diagnosis, that is, if there will be more than 5 mm of translation of the leg, that means the Lachman test is positive and the chances of ACL tear is high. Posterior draw test for PCL. The patient lies supine with the knee by 90 degrees. Examiner places thumbs over the anterolateral line and intermediate knee joint line. The examiner pushes the tibia posteriorly. The sagging of the tibia, if you see, when the examiner pushes the tibia posteriorly, If it is present, that means there are high chances of posterior muscle ligament injury or tear. So diagnosis again, it is in the RA we discussed. It is a gold standard investigation. This arthroscopy again, we can diagnose meniscal injuries or the cruciate ligament injuries with the help of arthroscopy also. Old energy triad, it occurs due to the 15 force of action on the surface, let's know what force foot. Old energy triad consists of injury to the three ligaments, that is ACL, MCL and ligament meniscus. The diagnosis is in the MRI, treatment involves surgical repair of the ACL followed by rest for physiotherapy and for MCL rehabilitation. Complications of these kinds of ligament injuries, knee instability and osteoarthritis. Treatment, how will you treat this kind of injuries? Conservative treatment, it is performed in grade 1 and grade 2 injuries of the ligaments and in patients presenting with unstable knee leading to sedentary lifestyle. If the patient is not having any high demanding lifestyle and the grade of injury is 1 to 2, we will go for conservative treatment. If the patient such as he is having very high demand lifestyle, such as a sports person, he has to undergo surgical treatment in cases of grade 1 and grade 2 injury also. Conservative treatment is the rest in mobilization by cast, above knee cast or cylindrical cast, and physiotherapy by for strengthening of the ligaments and the knees, knee muscles. Operative treatment, it is performed after 2 to 3 weeks after swelling subsides. Normally it is done after 5 to 6 weeks when the swelling and subsides and the hematoma that subsides. How it is done? By repair of the ligament. For grade 3 collateral ligament injury and for load preventing injury, reinforcement of facial or tendon graft. And reconstruction of the ligament, it is done by patients presenting load features with knee instability who has a rectal lifestyle such as in sports persons. So how the reconstruction is done? It is done by using the grafts and the tendon of facial aorta or from the semitendinosus graft or by the synthetic ligament. Now what are the synthetic ligaments? These are large artificial ligament and ABC purely polyester ligament, which are commonly used. Meniscal injuries of the knee. So the meniscal injuries, these are the intravascular venal and peritoneal meniscus of the knee, the medial and the lateral meniscus. How these meniscus get injured? Just a second. It can't be like that. Okay, I think that is enough for today, the supramandibular fractures and the cruciate ligament injuries. The meniscal injuries, the patellar dislocation and the tibial fractures we'll discuss in next class. Okay. Sita Sakko. Hello?
Yes sir.
We'll discuss the meniscal injuries, tibial bladder fractures and patellar dislocation in the next class. Today we'll discuss about the supramandibular fractures and the ligament injuries of the knee. I think that is enough for today. We'll discuss the other three topics in the next class. Okay.